the iPhone 18 series mass production testing to begin very soon. According to a recent rumor from China, Apple will start testing the iPhone 18 series smartphones on the mass manufacturing line one after another in the very early days of January. Then, the actual production is expected to commence shortly before the Chinese New Year, which in 2026 occurs on February 17. The iPhone 18 Pro mass manufacturing line has apparently already been set up, and this insider says the phone itself won't come with outward alterations as substantial as everyone appears to anticipate. It's unclear why Apple would want to start production of its iPhone 18 devices so early in the year, given the intention is still to introduce them in September. There's no rhyme or reason to this, so do take this rumor with an extra pinch of salt. Close-up of iPhone 18 Pro Max displaying its higher battery capacity. Apple's iPhone 18 Pro and Pro Max, expected for release in 2026, are likely to alter expectations in the smartphone market. With a combination of advanced technology, increased performance, and user-centric features, these devices are designed to adapt to the demands of current consumers. Here is an in-depth look at six important updates that illustrate Apple's commitment to innovation and functionality. 1. Expanded color options for personalization. Apple is offering three new color options: burgundy, light brown, and lighter purple. These enhancements go beyond the typical black and white, allowing a broader spectrum of choices to suit various tastes. The new palette balances sophistication and personality, allowing you to personalize your device in a way that suits your taste. Whether you favor strong or delicate tones, these colors provide a novel way to make your iPhone distinctively yours. 2. Larger battery for extended usage. The iPhone 18 Pro Max is expected to contain a 5,500 mAh battery, a major boost compared to its predecessors. While this innovation may result in a somewhat bigger and heavier device, the trade-off is a huge boost in battery life. This means you can enjoy continuous streaming, gaming, or multitasking for longer durations without constantly reaching for a charger. For customers who rely on their cell phones throughout the day, this upgrade promises better convenience and reliability. 3. Custom chips for superior performance. Apple is apparently building a new C2 or C2X chip aimed at increasing battery efficiency and enhancing communication. In addition, the arrival of the N2 chip will bring compatibility for Wi-Fi 8, delivering faster wireless rates and more robust connections. These advances aim to create a seamless user experience, especially in situations with high connectivity demands. Whether you're working remotely, watching high-definition content, or gaming online, these chips are built to keep your device running quickly and efficiently. 4. Satellite connectivity for remote access. In conjunction with Starlink, Apple aims to include satellite communication inside the iPhone 18 Pro Max. This function will help you to stay connected even in remote or isolated settings, such as deserts, mountains, or polar regions. It could also prove essential during flights or in emergency situations where regular networks are unavailable. For adventurers, regular travelers, or those living in locations with restricted coverage, this inclusion offers a huge step forward in making sure dependable communication is available wherever they are in the world. 5. Advanced camera sensor technology. Apple is teaming with Samsung to produce a three-layer stacked camera sensor, a new innovation targeted at enhancing photographic capabilities. This sensor is supposed to produce clearer photos, decreased noise, and increased overall photo quality. With speculations of a 64-megapixel sensor, the iPhone 18 Pro Max might provide professional-grade photography to everyday users. Whether you're taking rich vistas or delicate close-ups, our technology ensures that your images are sharp, colorful, and true to life. 6. Variable aperture for enhanced photography. The main camera on the iPhone 18 Pro Max is reported to include variable aperture technology, allowing it to alter its light intake dynamically. This capability optimizes the camera's performance in both bright and low-light circumstances, making sure great results regardless of the surroundings. Whether you're capturing a sunlit beach or a dimly lit concert, the camera will adapt to give photographs with the optimum mix of light and detail. This feature is particularly appealing for photography aficionados who seek adaptability and precision in their images. What this means for you? The iPhone 18 Pro and Pro Max are shaping up to be more than just incremental improvements. With longer battery life, faster connectivity, and novel camera functions, these products are designed to satisfy the increasing needs of today's customers. Apple's commitment to personalization, performance, and innovation ensures that the iPhone 18 Pro Max will not only keep up with modern demands, but also establish new milestones in smartphone technology. As 2026 unfolds, these upgrades reflect Apple's focus on enhancing user experience and keeping its position as a leader in the digital industry. Despite the enormous popularity of the iPhone 17 in 2025, the iPhone 18 is not projected to arrive until the spring of 2027, putting the iPhone 17 in the lineup as the latest standard model for almost 18 months. This would represent the first time Apple skips a whole calendar year without introducing a new iteration of its flagship non-Pro iPhone. For more than a decade, Apple has released its primary iPhone lineup in the fall, with all major models arriving concurrently in September. That pattern is likely to change this year, when the company is widely reported to split its next iPhone releases between two discrete release windows, rather than announcing the complete lineup at once. Under this plan, Apple is expected to favor higher-end models in the fall, while delaying lower-cost or standard models until the following year. As a result, Apple is not likely to ship the iPhone 18 in 2026. Instead, reports claim that Apple plans to introduce the iPhone 18 Pro, iPhone 18 Pro Max, and foldable iPhone in the normal fall timeframe, while keeping the basic iPhone 18 back until the spring of 2027, when it will arrive with the iPhone 18e and iPhone Air 2. The alleged shift is connected to Apple's expanding iPhone portfolio. With the arrival of the iPhone 16e and iPhone Air in 2025, the predicted debut of the first foldable iPhone in 2026, and the continued existence of older versions like the iPhone 16 and iPhone 16 Plus, there might be at least 8 separate iPhone models on sale from Apple by the end of 2026. A staggered release schedule would allow the business to further differentiate its models, provide them a longer sales window without internal competition, and spread iPhone debuts more equally across the year. Supply chain analysts have also pointed to manufacturing and logistical benefits as a driver behind the potential migration. By spacing out launches, Apple might alleviate production bottlenecks, better manage component supply for sophisticated technologies, and smooth revenue recognition across fiscal quarters, rather than focusing iPhone sales in a single time. Getting into the features, one of the most frequent rumors for the iPhone 18 Pro series is regarding the design improvements to the front of the phone. Apple may finally move past the dynamic island, which is the pill-shaped cutout that has been a feature since the iPhone 14 series, in lieu of a hole-punch camera cutout along with underscreen Face ID technology. This would purportedly greatly expand the screen's usable space and create a cleaner front-facing appearance. The front camera itself is also expected to be repositioned, likely to the top left corner of the display. Moreover, speculations also indicate that Apple could ultimately incorporate the full Face ID technology beneath the display, thereby removing the need for any front-facing cutouts beyond the camera. Next, in the rear, the Pro models are expected to retain the horizontal camera plateau known from former versions, though with major internal modifications. One of the most fascinating potentials is the inclusion of a variable aperture camera lens, presumably specific to the iPhone 18 Pro Max. This would allow the camera to adapt how much light it takes in different conditions, boosting low-light photography and allowing more control over depth of field. Rumors further indicate Apple is also experimenting on improved image sensors that could result in more quality and better dynamic range than before. Finally, behind the hood, both the Pro and Pro Max models are likely to be powered by Apple's A20 Pro CPU, which will use a completely new 2-nanometer manufacturing process. This chip offers increased performance and energy efficiency over its predecessors. Furthermore, there are also suggestions that Apple may also innovate on chip packing, putting components closer together on the wafer to increase performance and cut power usage. So, let me know in the comments section below. Thank you for watching. I look forward to seeing you in the upcoming video.